Hello again from Wick, St Fergus in Caithness, Scotland. We hope you're well and staying safe. Today I want to talk about humility and how we all need to strive for that. Let's hear what Scripture has to say about this. Reading from Philippians chapter 2, verses 1 to 8. In your relationship with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Amen. If you look at Jesus' background, it was very humble. No grand houses for him, no wardrobes full of expensive clothes. He had a mother who spoke of her own lowly background, and an earthly father who, when taking his son to the temple to be dedicated, had to offer the sacrifice of a poor person, two young pigeons, because they couldn't afford a lamb. He was born in a barn or a stable, with a feeding trough as his crib, and his first visitors were shepherds. He grew up in a town so despised that a common proverb asked, "Can any good thing come out of Nazareth?" If there ever was anyone who had good reason to be humble by society's standards, it was Jesus. But let's face it, he was superior in every way to everyone around him in all the ways that mattered. Mattered more than status or wealth or human power. He had no faults or weaknesses that would make someone ashamed. But instead of the pride and arrogance that might arise out of being powerful, what did we see in Jesus? The ultimate example of humility by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. For us today, humility is not so much a case of thinking less of yourself, but instead thinking about yourself less. No one should think less of themselves because God doesn't think less about his children. He loves us all, faults and all. In fact, thinking about yourself less would probably do some people a lot of good. For those heavily involved in social media, and I'm thinking about the people they call influencers, somehow they have to think about themselves more than the average person would. Their image and their actions are what makes them famous, so they have to keep thinking about what they're doing, how they say things, how they dress, and what other people think about them. But for the rest of us, thinking about ourselves less often and focusing on thinking about what other people need and how you can help them, that's where humility is to be found. When you can put other people first and yourself last, that's a pretty good way to develop humility. I know, we're all guilty of pride to some extent. It's not wrong to be full of pride over, say, your child's first Christmas play or how they behaved as a flower girl at someone's wedding. That's really just love showing through rather than the arrogance associated with pride. True humility doesn't seek out fame. It doesn't need to always be in the limelight, and it doesn't need praise from other people. True humility is not about thinking we are somehow better than other people because of our status, or because of the amount of money we've got, or where we were born, or even the colour of our skin. Do you know, I only recently discovered that the word humble comes from the Greek word humus, meaning earth. There you go. A humble person can rise to the occasion and shine because they're always safely anchored, grounded, and down to earth. A Reverend Chris Lee wrote, In nature, a peacock is beautiful and seeks attention, while the snow leopard is rare, beautiful, and powerful. I would rather see a snow leopard. Humble confidence is equally rare, beautiful, and powerful. Well said indeed, reverently. Jesus had that true strength that doesn't exert itself but rests confidently in its own truth, that it can and will overcome. He gave us the ultimate example of humility by becoming obedient even to death on a cross for us. And he lives on as an example for us to try and follow. Enjoy listening to the music track this morning. It's David Archuleta singing I Know He Lives. Until the next time, God bless and stay safe.
I don't have to see him. I don't have to touch his hands to know that those nails pierce through to save the sinful man. I don't have to be there. Don't have to roll the stone away to know that he rose from the dead to overcome the grave. I know he lives. I know he lives. Jesus the Lamb, the great I am. I know he lives. Even in my worry, even in my darkest hour, his love is enough to fill me up and lift me higher. And when I fail to do right, I get down on my knees. Yeah, amazing grace, how sweet the sound, saving a wretch like me. I know he lives. I know he lives. Jesus the Lamb, the great I am. I know he lives. Father, I thank thee for your one and only. From the death on Calvary, from the tomb that is empty, I know he lives. I know he lives. I know he lives. Jesus the Lamb, the great I am. I know he lives. Oh yeah, I know he lives. Jesus the Lamb, the great I am. I know he lives.